Alrighty, guys, so with that said, let's do this. Jump back in there. I had to look for the load for a second. Yeah, see, we are at 45% done with this game. Not bad for a first stream. So where we left off, we were doing this mission, which took us a little while, but we were basically fighting a bunch of other biker gangs on a motorcycle to get progressively better weapons until we took out this one guy. We could basically take his goggles and find their secret hideout, which is where we are right now. Let's make sure there's nothing here. Yep, just our bike.
I don't spelunk.
Oh, wait, can we not go this way? Skywalker, what's up, buddy? How are you doing? Good to see you. That's interesting. So I just got here. Oh, wait, oh no, I go this way?
I don't spelunk.
Wait, which way do I go? I go this way?
I don't spelunk.
Nope. I tried to go right?
I don't spelunk.
I think he doesn't spelunk, guys. What am I supposed to do? I don't see another exit.
I don't spelunk.
This is not looking good for the stream. Here I was just saying, oh yeah, we could probably beat the game tonight. Am I supposed to get back on my bike? I feel like if I get on my bike, we're going to leave this place. I don't want to do that, but I don't see any other options. We don't have much in our inventory. We have a chainsaw. I mean, that's cool. We have a chain, a tire iron.
This chain could never handle my horsepower.
And then this weird goop that we found.
This stuff reeks.
I'm not sure what to do with that yet. I guess it is, because you could say you go spelunking, kind of like driving, I suppose. Oh yeah, so normally the goggles, Arthur, would appear right here at the top right, and you click on that to use them, but I think they might only work on the bike. Well, let's try using the bike. Maybe I have to continue exploring this area on the bike. I'm doing really good, Skywalker. This is my Friday, so I'm so excited. No work for the next 3 days. Life is good. How about you? So now that I'm on the bike, can I go into the cave? I'm not sure which way I came from, to be honest. No! I think I went backwards. Okay, luckily, I think I remember how to get back in there. So, see how it says exit at the bottom left? I'm waiting for it to say cave, and then I have to click at that exact moment to find the hidden cave. Exit, exit. Huh? Not there. It took me a long time to figure this out, with your guys' help, of course. Yeah, without these goggles, you'd never find the exit. I feel like we're a Terminator with this kind of vision. Okay, I think it's like right underneath this bridge. Reload, reload. I guess I could. That would have been quicker, huh? Well, we're already here. If I miss this, the next one, we might just reload. Exit, exit. How long is this thing? Let's let one more go by. I'm getting your bibliography ready for your research paper. Oh, that's exciting. When is it due? Is it due this weekend or next week? Exit, exit. It's not showing up. Okay, we're gonna load. I don't know what's different. So obviously, I need to go this way. It seems like everybody hates bibliographies. Even Phantasma, who is an academic. All right, so this goes further into the cave. There we go. Oh, so I just can't do any of this off of my bike. We have to do all this travel on our motorcycle. There's the ramp we were looking for. We need this to get over a bridge that collapsed. Those are some creepy faces in the background. They're like sharing an eye, or I guess this mask. Can we put this in our pocket? It's a big ramp. Oh, sweet, we attached it to our motorcycle. Perfect. What else do we have here? There's not much else. Like, look at this thing.
Everything about these guys is creepy.
You know, his voice isn't exactly the same, but it reminds me a little bit of Duke Nukem, if you guys ever played those games. Oh, I do not miss APA format. That was always so frustrating. Oh my gosh. So you got about 3 weeks. We're going to go ahead and knock it out. And hopefully by the middle of next week. That's great, Skywalker. Kudos to you for not procrastinating. I'm fantastic at procrastinating. So what's the deal with all the lasers going on there?
Don't think I'm getting in there.
Oh, that's cool. I like threw something through there. All right, so some kind of defense system. So, I guess I could take it off. Did I just take it off? No, I think it's still connected. Okay. I was gonna say, could I try to drive through that? It would probably kill us. All right, I guess let's drive out of here with our ramp. And you've been watching Star Wars Rebels, and you have to say it is hilarious that they have selective amnesia that happens for the sake of the children watching. They're like, Lord Vader, who's that? A lot of games do that too, honestly, almost to kind of remind you of what's going on. Or just a storytelling technique, but it definitely helps the kids understand for sure. Oh no, are they coming? Crap, they found me. We're in trouble. I'm not even wearing my goggles. Do I need to put them on?
Where'd he go?
And who was he?
My brothers, we have been visited by a spirit.
I just ditched the ramp.
The spirit of Ricky Myron, come to reclaim his ramp.
Why did he leave it here?
He can't use it because he is a spirit. He is only expressing his anger, which we must honor. Oh, angry spirit of Ricky Myron, we honor your rage. But for now, the ramp must go back.
No! They're gonna put it back. Darn it. What do we do with our motorcycle? They found a good hiding spot for it. That's what we did. Okay, so we have to convince them more that we're a god and we need to take this ramp, perhaps? I wonder if I can... Do I have any items that I could put down to kind of convince them to let me keep it? This is an interesting one. I might not have all the puzzle pieces as well. Oh, see, now this thing lights up. Okay, that's different. I wonder if I can use any of my items on these masks in the back. I'm scared he's going to destroy it.
I'm saving that chain for my friends on the old mine road.
Okay, so we're going to hold on to the chain to fight stuff. How about this goop?
I should save something that potent for the mine road.
Most of these are weapons we've been using, so he might not throw any of them away.
It's meant for nuts.
For nuts?
I'd like to wrap this around Ripburger's neck.
It's a pipe wrench. How is that meant for nuts? Wait, never mind. I understand. That's disgusting and painful.
I'm saving the gas for the mine road.
Okay, so there's not much we can do with any of those. Can we do one of those on the ramp?
I should save something that potent for the mine road.
Oh, is there more? I totally missed that, Hasifa. Good call. Yeah, there's like a little next button right here. So we have a few items. We have a 2x4 as well, and this big skull mace, which is awesome. And here's our mask. Can we use it? I don't know if I can put it on.
I don't think that's how they're used.
Let me get into the front, though. No, Phantasma. So the guy that was in here last stream, Maurice, he was the limo driver for the bad guy's car. And he also played Pinky in the Brain, and I checked him out on Wikipedia, and there was a ton of characters from different things that I've seen, both recently and a long time ago, that he was in. Like, if you look at his list, you probably enjoy a lot of his stuff. It's amazing how much stuff he's done. Like, he was, what surprised me is he was Egon in the old Ghostbusters cartoon, and he's continued doing the role even up to the new ones, which just blew my mind. It's like, oh, I used to love the Ghostbusters cartoon. Okay, so I can't use it there. What if we look at the lasers here with it? Maybe we'll see a weak spot.
I don't think that's how they're used.
No, we can't do that. And Mark Hamill, I think, is actually the bad guy.
Incredible the kind of weapons you find out in the road.
When I looked at the pipe wrench, I think it said the character's name. Something with Burger in it.
I'm saving that for...
I wonder if we can lick the lasers.
I'm saving the gas for the mine road.
I was thinking, can we combine these items together? I'm not sure. We could try Relentless.
I'm not putting my lips on that.
Nope.
Don't think I'm getting in there. Everything about these guys is creepy.
Okay, well, we can get on our motorcycle. I wonder if we could try to use the ramp. This seems like it would kill us. Ripburger, that's it. Thank you. Oh, he actually does three characters in this game. That's really cool. No, it looks like when I'm on the motorcycle... There's no other directions to go but this way. Well... I'm gonna try to take it again. I'm guessing the same thing's gonna happen. I wonder if I was supposed to do something else on that QuickTime event. Yay, 23 appointments today, Dingo. Oh my gosh, how many appointments do you usually have in a day? Now that sucks to be so stressed out and busy, but it does make the time go by really fast. Mark Hamill's just playing all the bad guys. Wait, where was my thing? I actually don't have it. I thought I connected it. Maybe I disconnected it on accident. Whoops, I think I unattached it when I was messing around with it. Let me reattach it. Yeah, the only thing I could think of, because I can't seem to interact with much here, is that during that chase scene, I have to do something special to get them off my tracks or convince them I'm the god. Or maybe I'm just supposed to fight them. I'm not sure. Okay, now it's connected. I also wonder, now that it's right here, we did stop at that next screen, that's true.
I'm not taking any strolls in here.
I'm not sure why we did stop there, that's a good point. I wonder if I can do something there ahead of time. It is attached right now. Let's see if we still stop there. I'm not sure if we stop there when we have it attached, but I'm gonna try. Yeah, it would be weird seeing Mark Hamill as a villain in live action, wouldn't it? Okay, we can get out right here. Alright. Oh, I see what he's doing. Oh, crap. Nice, that's clever. You might have missed that. It was very subtle. But we use the ramp to chip off some of those little road...
I'm done with these boys.
...lights in the middle that they use to see, basically. Nice. All right, that was... I didn't even realize I was doing that. I just kind of did that on accident. That's my favorite way to solve a puzzle. He was a villain on Criminal Minds. Was it not very convincing, I'm guessing? And Dingo, each day varies. The amount of stress varies by how many appointments there are. I guess you could have a lot of appointments, but they could all be easy, in which case that's like the best. The reps are assigned those appointments and the roofs of each house. And if we get bad rep and a horrid roof, it's just mentally exhausting. I mean, that's how it was when I used to work at the video store, for sure. Where I work right now, I don't have to deal with like the general public, but when I did, a busy day I thought was okay, as long as everybody was cool. But you get some bad apples in there, and they can just wreck your entire week. Almost trying to start a fight with you. Oops. Get back on there. I tried to move the motorcycle. Actually, I have to click on there. He was great on there, but you just kept thinking it's Luke. There's a lot of actors like that. Like poor Elijah Wood. It's hard to not see him as a hobbit. And the guy that plays Harry Potter. Things like that. All right. We're going to take this ramp and hopefully we don't wreck our bike. I should probably save it before we do this. There might be more to this puzzle I don't know. Luckily, I'm pretty sure this game doesn't have a fail state where you can break it and not continue. So I'm not creating multiple saves, but I don't really think I have to. Wait, how do I use it? Oh, I guess I gotta leave and then come back, huh? And we just gotta keep driving straight. He won't turn off to this exit. So I guess I need to take an exit and then turn around. Elegant Frost, how are you doing? It's good to see you again. What's going on? Actually, if I keep going this way, don't I eventually run into that big spill? I could use that area to turn around, I think. There it is. Yeah, so we'll stop here. That is true, Artho. That was a fail state, but I think that was a bug more than anything. However, what if I ran into a bug right before a save, or right after a save, I guess, and I couldn't get past it? There's a good reason to have multiple saves. Okay, so let's go back the way we came, and we should hit the ramp this time. And Elegant, have you ever played this game before? I wonder if it matters where I am. And we just want to stay on this road going straight. Same, Relentless, same. Aw, look at Harry Potter go. I did see him in a horror movie called The Woman in Black. I thought it was pretty good, and I thought Daniel Radcliffe did a great job. I thought he was going to do the ramp. All right, is there something else I need to do? Maybe I have to interact with this. Maybe it's not actually set up. It looks like it's set up. It was a pretty creepy movie. It was a slow burn, but it had
looks good where it is.
It had some good scares on it. Is there any other place on the screen? Let's see. Oh, there's the gorge.
No. Echo. 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 Echo.
That's great.
I got everything except for that auto hover lift.
Oh, I'm missing another item. I completely forgot about that. What was the deal with the auto hover lift? There was a car that had it, right? I think we saw a car using that. Is that how you would translate what I said? I'm curious if I had subtitles on what it would look like. I don't remember the dog in that movie, Phantasma, although it's been a very long time since I've seen it. Well, at least it didn't die. They just don't mention it again. So you got to assume the dog's totally fine, living its life. Andy's the same way. She'll always be asking, where's the dog? Maybe I'm supposed to take the exit and try to find that other piece to this puzzle. But I could have sworn it was on a car. So, like, I don't think I need to fight these guys. Yeah, they're not going to have it. Oh, ghosts don't want to hurt dogs. They just want to torture us. That's what I like to pretend. Or maybe we're going to see another vehicle or bike that has a hover thing. I thought it was on a car, though. That's right. Well, hold on. There was a car that chased us when we went this way, I believe, right? It's hard to know which way you're really going on this road. But yeah, I think I need to go back the opposite side of the bridge, and that's where we can find the car. Oh, there was a sign that gave us directions, right? Yeah. Well, if we're going towards the bridge, which I might be, I just don't even know, we'll check out that sign again. Oh, Dingo, that's something you just gotta not even worry and think about. Age doesn't mean too much. More than anything, it just means he's been working there longer than you. Okay, so...
one of the gorge's many casualties.
Well, we read about him. I think we look at this.
Tightrope walkers, hang gliders, human cannonballs. Many have tried to cross the mighty Cuyahoga Gorge, and many have failed. Except for Ricky Myron, the Flying Torch, who jumped the gorge on a stock Corley motorcycle.
That's the same
it
name those guys mentioned.
It was later uncovered that he had modified his Corley with a pre-regulation destroyer class solid fuel recoil booster and an automotive hover lift. Myron said he would gladly replicate the jump to clear his name, but his special ramp was stolen by a mysterious truck hijacking motorcycle gang.
We got that.
I got everything except for that auto hover lift.
I love it how he tells you that, just in case you're not sure what you even picked up yet. Here you go. Okay. So yeah, I think we could just follow the road the opposite way and get to that car and somehow steal that. That's a good point, Phantasma. I like that. After 25, age is just a number. It doesn't matter much. But before the age of 25, your age kind of controls a few things. Can you vote? Can you drink? Can you rent a car? Certain things like that. Then after that, it's just a number. Can you gamble? Also changes depending on where you are in the world. That's true, Phantasma. Yes, I remember at the current job I'm working at, I started there when I was 24. And you can rent a car before you're 25. It just costs a lot more. Luckily for me, I did rent a car when I was 24, and it wasn't my money. The company had to pay that cost. So I'm like, ah, that's cool, whatever. Yeah, I think it's over here somewhere. Now we're going the right way. There's the car. So it's gonna chase us.
Look at him run.
That's Maurice. That was the guy that we talked to yesterday in stream. And I remember he mentioned he was going for like a Vincent Price type of voice. That's so cool. So with him chasing me, I think I need to stop here.
Watch it.
Yeah, see, there's something we have to do there to wreck him. Because he's still following us, but he can't catch us. So, I guess we might as well...
cavefish.
I was going to say, we might as well just turn around, get back to that place, and try to put a trap or something there. Which... now I'm scared. Are we going to kill Maurice's character? That'd be so sad. You know, I always make that joke, Dingo, how you say about the half a brain cell. When I'm working together with some friends on a project or something. It's like, oh, with all of us working together, we form one fully functioning adult. We should be able to do this. Okay, so let's take this exit. And then we're going the right way, so we can stop here. So we already picked up some of that goop. Can I do anything else with this? Actually, if it's a hover thing, anything I put in here, it's not going to, like, maybe it'd pick it up or something and wreck it. I don't know.
I've touched it enough.
It's not going to, like, wreck the tires because it doesn't have tires. I'm just wondering if I could put something here as a trap.
I'm saving the gas, but I'm saving that chain from a...
We already have goop. That wouldn't make sense
I
to put
save
more
something
goop.
That poor... I'm saving that for the mine road.
So another idea, maybe we have to put more goop that we picked up on the ramp area, and then when he follows me all the way there, he'll wreck himself on that side, because that's where he turns around when he gets to the end of the road. Because it doesn't seem like any of my items work here as like a trap or something.
A thing like that has only one use, the old mine road.
Or is there something I can do with this? Did I never interact with this thing before? I could have sworn I did. But is he climbing on top? What is he doing? I kind of lost track of the character.
Won't budge.
He walked all the way around to try to open it. That's funny. Can I
use it's meant for nuts.
Can I use any items to open it?
I'm saving...
Chainsaw should open it.
I'm saving.
Darn it. Where'd he go? I think he might be walking back around. Yep, there he is. Take your time. We're not in a hurry.
A thing like that has only one use. I'm saving that for the mine road.
Well, let's look at it. Maybe he'll give us a hint.
Looks like him had dropped a load here.
Can we kick it or attack it or something?
I ain't looking to buy.
I'm not trying to... Oh, I guess because if you kick the tires, that makes sense.
It's bolted on.
Oh, so there's multiple things here, actually. There's the entire trailer, and then there's the tire. At first, when I did the highlight, I didn't realize it was two different things being highlighted. Is there anything else? Semi-trailer. Yeah, I think it's just the tires. Okay. Can we use this to remove one of the tires? It said it's bolted on. Hey, there we go.
Well, that's all of them. Can't be much holding that up now.
So now do we need to move it?
The truck has them pinned. I ain't looking to buy.
So what could we do with the truck now?
A lot of weight on those babies.
So the question is, do we still have to move something, or when the car comes, is it going to have enough force to cause that thing to move over now that they're not connected? I kind of doubt it. It's making it sound like everything's still too much. Oh, before when we tried to like use it, he like went all the way back around towards the back and tried to do something. Oh, maybe now it'll move that the tires aren't connected. I assume he's doing something. We just gotta wait. Gotta be patient. Maybe I'm clicking on the wrong spot. I think I'm clicking up here, so he keeps going towards the back of it. I gotta click over here. Now where are you going? I literally just clicked there. I'm not sure what he's doing. When I first clicked on that, I thought he might be trying to climb up to the top. Oh gosh. He was tilting the whole thing. I had no idea what he was trying to do. I thought maybe he was trying to get in there. Holy crap, is that guy strong? Well, all right.
What a mess.
So with this here now...
I'd call that a road hazard.
Okay, now I think it's going to be enough of a obstruction to stop those guys. So now we're going to go back that way and piss them off, chase them back here, and this should wreck them. I was a little worried about that elegant. I really thought that might destroy our bike, which that would have been a game over at that point. Yeah, let's go get Maurice. Ew, Relentless, now that you mention it. A little bit. Why are they hauling that? Is it all one person's? I don't know. Oh, the boulder punching. Yeah, it's like a feat of strength that is so huge it almost makes no sense. Although the boulder punching was especially funny. All right. I love that. We just kind of come up, nanner, nanner, nanner.
Look at him run.
Oh, I wonder if it matters where we are. I think the safe spot would be like right here. I doubt that it matters where you are on the road, but I think this is the opening based on where we knocked it down. Here it comes. Oh yeah, that's more in the road now. Yeah. There's much more of that stuff in the road.
Boss, it was Nestor's fault.
Get in quick. I have a plan. We're going to lure the Corley women out of hiding with a bike.
That's Mark Hamill.
She already has a bike.
Yes, but this one she worked on with her father. It's an emotional thing. Don't try to understand.
You don't have emotions. Hurry. Oh, I knew. Okay, so they're going to ditch their car because they're going to go help them. I'm going to save it real quick, and then we'll go scrap the hover parts we need from the car. And now, just in case I manage to break it, let's create another save. Every time. Is that Mark Hamill? Is that one? I mean, he plays three characters, so... I mean, you got like a... I don't know, 1 in 5 chance maybe? I'm not sure how many speaking characters there are in this game. Although that happens a lot with voice actors. They will play multiple parts in the same game because, and why not? You're there. Most of the other parts are probably going to be smaller bit parts anyway. And these voice actors are so dynamic, you can't tell unless you look it up. Okay, yeah, let's take the stop. And you know, I just realized something. I was doing some recording stuff yesterday, and I think I might have screwed up my microphone. You might not notice it, but I did... Let me just check real quick. Yes, I turned off my noise gate. Which, without a noise gate, if I make any little sound, like just... a mouth sound, maybe I breathe in deeply, something, the mic will pick it up. But with a noise gate, I have to make a noise over a certain threshold, otherwise the mic just throws it out, which is great, because there's a lot of noises. If my wife is showering or one of the dogs does some little noise, you guys don't hear it usually. Is that Mark Hamill? I wish. That'd be great. Let's see. When your friend made you watch Game of Thrones, you were like, is that Jon Snow's mom? And every time she would just say, no. Jon Snow's mom, man, she stood out in that. And apparently, I haven't read the books, but I guess Lady Stark has a much different story in the books than she does in the show, which is really interesting. I need to read those.
That's trashed.
You couldn't tell it was off? That's good, because that means I'm generally fairly quiet anyway. But if I just kind of like went back here, went... Oh, let's pick that up. Okay, I have to give it a second. Yeah, see, I'm making some noises and it's just not picking it up. Which, without the noise gate, it hears everything.
I don't touch anything without wheels.
Well, you are going to have to touch this one. ooh, do we chainsaw it off? I don't have the pipe wrench anymore.
I'm saving the gas for the mine road.
No, we don't take it that way.
I'm saving that chain. I'm saving. A thing like that has only one use.
Maybe this has multiple things road to interact with. Oh yeah, it looks like there's a special thing right there. The fender, okay.
I don't touch anything without wheels.
There's like the hovercraft and then the fender.
I'm saving that chain.
I hope I'm clicking on the right spot. It's kind of hard to tell. Oh, maybe I can kick the fender.
No.
No? You can just kick it for fun. Let's look at the fender.
Now there's one thing I've never needed.
The fender? Okay.
I don't touch anything without wheels.
Hmm. Yeah, this is for the mine road. This is for the mine road. It's kind of telling us we're only going to use this for combat. Nothing else. Oh, I do have the wrench still. My bad. I forgot I can go back and look at more items. Sweet. Okay, what do we get? The hover car part?
It's a single hover lift unit.
It looks like a computer fan. So we can attach that to our bike, right?
Looks okay for an aftermarket part.
Sweet. All right, I think we're ready to go. So, Phantasma, did you enjoy Game of Thrones when you watched it? Man, that ending was so disappointing, but I still gotta say, like, the first 4 or 5 seasons was probably some of my favorite TV I think I've ever watched. I was always really excited when the new episodes are coming out. From start to end, you didn't like it. Oh, wow. I had different strokes. But yeah, Andy and I, we were enthralled for the majority of the show runtime. Okay, so... Oh, there we go. Now we have an arrow to go. Sweet.
All right. I've modified my bike enough.
Let's do this. We need a long run for this. Oh, we get a first person view. That's cool. There goes the hover jets. Nice. You know, after playing this game, I could see why Tim Schafer wanted to make Brutal Legend. Have you guys ever played that game? I can see some similarities in certain ways. It's a very different type of game, but very bikes and metal and all that kind of stuff. You know, I think I've only ever seen Emilia Clarke and like one other thing. I can't remember what it
those
is.
Those weapons were out of weight.
Oh, we got rid of all those weapons. Hey, because it's only for the mine road and we're not going back there. Okay, this is a perfect time to save it. Kit Harington, yes. You know, the first time I saw Kit Harington was Silent Hill Revelations, one of the worst movies I've ever seen, mostly because I'm a big Silent Hill fan, but it was just awful. I enjoyed the first Silent Hill movie, but the second one was just so bad. So bad.
The Corley Motors Factory. Holy ground.
This is where they make all the motorcycles. Look how tiny our little sprite is there. What does this look like in pixel art? You can't even tell that's a person. It's like four pixels. That's so cute. In this mode, you can actually tell it's him. Oh, that was a catchy song, wasn't it, Dingo? I also really enjoyed The Witcher. I'm looking forward to a season two of that. I wouldn't say it was nearly as high quality as Game of Thrones, but it was more of a fun romp kind of thing. I never read the books, so I can't compare what The Witcher show did to the books, but you know, a big part of why I think the show went off the rails is because they ran out of material from George R.R. Martin. The poor guy, he still hasn't finished his books, and he said he was going to be done long before the show caught up to him. Well, that was a lie, and they had like cliff notes, I guess, of like kind of the big story beats, but they had to fill in all the little details and try to make it more, you know, more interesting, more dramatic. And they were just making stuff up and it just wasn't as good as the original stuff. Where are we going?
Looks like something big's going on in there.
You know, Henry Cavill was one of those actor choices, and when I first heard it, I'm like, no, don't do that. But I did the same thing with Heath Ledger as the Joker, because all I had known him for was like romantic comedies and those kind of movies. So it's like, how are you gonna make him the Joker? And he blew it out of the water. And I thought Henry Cavill also did a fantastic job as the Witcher. Exactly, Phantasma. I've seen there's some directors like that where when they write a movie, I'm not as interested. If they are adapting something else, they could do a great job directing it.
Looks like something big's going on in there.
All right, I don't think there's anything else to really look at. Oh, there's a sign up here.
Cool.
Just cool. All right, I guess we're going inside. I've only played, well, actually, no, I finished The Witcher 2 and The Witcher 3. I never finished the first Witcher game. I never played it. I saw my little brother play it way back in the day before I even knew what it was, and the gameplay is very different in The Witcher 1 compared to the sequels. It's much more methodical. It's not quite turn-based, but it doesn't feel like an action RPG.
Just like the cell doors in Solitary. I'm here for the shareholders meeting.
Mr. Ripburger has postponed the meeting until Mr. Corley's murderers are apprehended. All the shareholders were notified.
Yeah. Well, I haven't checked my voicemail lately, Mac.
Ooh, so we're going to have to somehow convince them that the murderer has been apprehended so we can have a shareholder meeting? That's a big door.
That's one big door.
Let's kick it open. Oh, no.
Let me in.
Beat it.
Jerk.
That's our solution to everything, is just kick it open. Yeah, I could see Sherlock not really working for Henry Cavill not really working for Sherlock as much. I haven't watched that show. And you haven't read The Witcher books, but you are working on finishing the games, Platypus. When it comes to fantasy, you prefer the books instead of the movies or TV shows. Yeah, because, I mean, fantasy stuff, I think, is some of the hardest things to capture properly to film. So I think often it's just better to have it in your mind as you read the details.
Let me in.
Beat it.
That said,
jerk.
I did love Lord of the Rings. I really enjoyed that series.
Hey, open up. Let me in.
Beat it.
Jerk.
Well, is there any... We don't have anything for items, really.
It's meant for nuts. It's meant for nuts. I'm saving that chain for my friends on the old mine road.
And then there's a sign right up here.
Hey, Corley Motors. I've been meaning to come here for years. This is really a religious pilgrimage for me. A religious pilgrimage with a lot of butt kicking.
I was about to say, this is probably a pilgrimage for him. Isn't it elegant? Lord of the Rings did such a good job. The Hobbit movies were fun, but they weren't nearly as interesting to me. Okay, oh.
Souvenirs here.
There we go. There was another way to go.
We got your hat.
Look at that little
pennant.
Bunny.
We got it all right here. Official Corley.
You not like the bunny?
Drive your own derby. All right, let's see the cash, amigo.
Hallelujah.
No bucks, no yucks, compadre.
Is that a real bunny we could just buy?
Our bunnies come with batteries included. Lovable, lovable little bunny.
That's what happened.
The officially licensed bunny of the Corley Motors Smashatorium. We got your t-shirts here. All sizes and colors. What can I get you?
Okay, why are all the lights down here?
Why all the lights down here?
We got a demolition derby tonight. First prize is a vintage Corley hardtail, completely restored by the old man himself. Yep.
I think we might have to participate in this. Now, they're working on another Lord of the Rings series, aren't they? I think on Amazon. I think it's like a prequel to what was in the films. They were also working on a Lord of the Rings MMO, but I heard that got canceled, which is a bummer. We don't have any new big MMOs, honestly. That's a good point, Phantasma. Yeah, they didn't have that issue when they had the source material. Once they lose that, the writing went downhill fast. That is true. There is the older Lord of the Rings MMO, which was just trying to cash in on the World of Warcraft craze. I want to see like a brand new one, try to do something a little different rather than just trying to, you know, copy something for a successful formula. I heard it's not bad. And if you're into Lord of the Rings, it's interesting to like see all the places and stuff, but now it probably looks fairly dated, I'm guessing. So, what's a big arena doing way down here?
What's this big arena doing way out here?
Corley built the Smashatorium so his employees could have some wholesome entertainment nearby. He sure took care of his employees. I got no idea what's going to happen to us now that he's gone.
We need a good souvenir.
I'm looking for a good souvenir.
Well, good souvenirs is all I got. What can I fix you up with?
Something small, fury, and yellow. I'm not sure what we really need, honestly. But probably that bunny.
Something small, furry, and yellow.
Sorry, this is the only set of teeth I got.
Ew.
Dang, there goes another one.
How about the car?
How about that little car there?
It's small, but it's not cheap, my friend. You better just take it for a test drive to make sure.
We need bunnies.
Bunnies, and plenty of them.
You want bunnies? I got your bunnies. How much you got on you?
Can I just take them out for a test drive?
I think you may not be ready for the kind of commitment that comes with a Corley Bunny Value Pack. Sorry, son.
Wait, how many bunnies do you get? That could be a lot of responsibility. And Elegant, you think Amazon will probably never get any of the games out? It seems like all the projects they announced have major issues. Yeah, even the other MMO they were working on. It was like in beta and then it got taken down and I'm not sure what the status of that is right now. Yeah, so far they haven't had a solid release yet, which is so weird. They have so much money. They could do so many incredible things with that, you would think. Honestly, maybe it's the problem of them trying to create a new studio. Maybe they got to go the Amazon route and just buy a studio that already is successful. You think strongly narrative books and movies don't make good MMOs and vice versa? Yeah, because, I mean, Warcraft, I guess there are books, but it was mostly based on the games, which had much simpler lore to dive into. What's the best game they've released? I'm not even sure what they've successfully released. I have heard that Star Wars MMO was pretty good. What about the one before that? Was it called Star Wars Galaxies? I had some friends that played that and enjoyed it. I never tried it myself. Okay, can we get those shirts in extra, extra large?
Those shirts come in extra, extra large.
No, but they're pre-shrunk.
No thanks.
Darn it. And what do those pennants say on them?
What do those pennants say on them?
Can't beat a Corley, they say. Kind of ironic, actually, considering how he died. Still, look great on your bedroom wall.
No walls. My bike is my home.
We could set you up with a little pole so you could make a flag, you know, for your back seat.
I'll think about it.
Do you actually have any money?
As much as I need.
Yeah, we don't have any money. Also, Platypus, being a Star Trek fan, did you ever play that VR Star Trek game? Where you're, I think it's called Bridge Crew. I have it, but I haven't tried it myself. And they need someone to run their game studio, Phantasma, who has experience and who is focused on doing something innovative instead of chasing down things. Speaking of that, I think it was Google had hired on, what was her name, Jade something. She was like the writer, director, or she was involved with like creating Assassin's Creed, which turned into a huge thing. And I don't know what happened there, but I think she left. So that didn't work out. I think it was Google. Maybe it was Amazon. Any vultures?
Seen any vultures around here?
Nah, we don't have much of a vulture problem here.
Oh my goodness.
Even though their hideout is right up the road. They stay pretty much locked up in there. Not very social.
Chopfla, welcome raiders to Johncadia. How are you doing, Chopfla? Welcome, everybody. Thank you for dropping in. Thank you for the raid, Chopfla. How was your stream? What were you playing? You were doing some more Ghost of Tsushima. How is that game going? I've heard it's a really big game. Are you just trying to complete it for your first time, or have you already beaten it and you're doing extra stuff right now? Last time when you raided on Tuesday, I was just wrapping things up. We had like 10 seconds to go, so I could hardly say anything. But now we can actually chat a little bit. Thank you again, dude. I really appreciate that. How was your stream? Okay, let's ask him what's in the hat. It looks like a beer hat, which is amazing.
What's in the hat?
I don't know. Came filled with it. Probably some sort of packing material. Packs a punch, I'll tell you that much.
Wait, you're drinking that?
Looky here. Nothing personal, but why don't you mosey along and stop scaring away all the other customers, all right?
Just clearing my throat.
There's no other customers.
Fill our handy beverage hats.
Oh no, Chopfla, this is the perfect time. We just started our stream and I have no work tomorrow, so this is going to be a long one. So today's perfect. I was talking about how yesterday was. Unfortunately, we were just ending when you came.
Come give our derby car a spin. Looky here. Nothing personal.
Oh.
But why don't you mosey along and stop scaring away all the other customers, all right?
Oops. I actually have nothing else to talk to him about. That's a bummer.
Buy your kids a bunny so they'll shut up on the long drive
Pigeon.
Home.
Thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to the stream. Okay, so with that said, can I grab this Atari controller?
Don't be a cheap jerk. Buy something.
Oh, we can control the car.
Sure, sure. Take it for a spin.
That's cool.
Just don't go out of range.
Looks like it's getting weak.
Oh, great. You killed the batteries.
That was quick.
If we don't got it, then it stinks.
Oh, yeah. I think it's dead.
It's out of juice.
Pat the bunny. You know you want to.
You know, Phantasma, to get the bunny, I think we have to win that destruction derby he was talking about.
I'm practically giving this loot away. All right, let's see the cash, amigo.
I'll owe you.
No bucks, no yuck.
Yeah, we don't have cash for it, unfortunately.
What's a couple of bucks in it?
No.
These souvenirs all have an expected appreciation rate of 3.
It's a joystick, probably for that little car.
Which is useless right now. We need some more batteries or something for it. Let's go this way. And the game is amazing, Chopfla. You look forward to when I start it, and you needed to... We nerded out and talked about the design and music. Oh, isn't that so much fun? Just to like appreciate all the things a game does right. Have you already beaten it, or are you still working on your first playthrough? So I guess first prize is not bunnies. It's another motorcycle. Do we need another motorcycle? I don't think so.
That's the old hardtail Mo restored with Malcolm.
Oh, we do need that because that's Mo's bike.
No.
So is this how we get to the competition?
It's the exit. It only spins one way, and it's the wrong way.
Okay, so we can't go in that way. Got it. Looks like the rest of this is a dead end. You're doing chapter 2, just doing the side quests and leveling up. It's a big game, I've heard. I don't know how many hours it takes, but it's probably a big commitment.
It's the exit. It's the exit. It only spins one way, and it's the wrong. I'm not going in there. They all think I killed their beloved leader.
Oh, we actually got him to try to go in there. Okay.
That's right. Official Corley Motor Smashatorium souvenirs.
Maybe instead of cash, we can give him something else.
Come on, give me a break.
We don't have much.
Remind you.
I'm saving that chain for my friends on the...
We got your pennants. I'm practically gift.
It's meant for nuts.
Lovable, lovable little bunnies.
Oh, there are actually a few other things we can look at, too.
The Corley Motor Smashatorium. We got
there goes Georgie.
Souvenirs here.
It's a whole box of those furry
I'm going to mute this for a second.
And it's cheap, too.
Oh, he's here. Hi, Georgie. What are you so excited about, huh, buddy? Come here, Georgie, come here. Here's our
you, big fella. Come give our derby car a spin.
Barking now, huh?
Buy your kids a bunny so they'll shut up on the long drive home.
Georgie, come here.
Pat the bunny. Georgie. You know you want to. Drive your own derby car by remote control. Our bunnies come with batteries included. If we don't got it, then it stinks. We got it all right here.
He's so upset. I don't know what he's pissed at.
What are you pissed at, buddy? What are you pissed at?
Somebody made some noise outside. George is just not having it.
Buy your kids money so they'll shut up on the long drive home.
Excuse me, but are those shirts, are they all cotton?
Well, let's just see here. ...100% cotton.
Oh. That's too bad. I'm allergic to cotton.
There we go.
Official Corley Motors merchandise.
I didn't kill it. I stole the bunny. So the solution to that, unfortunately, is you distract him looking at the shirts to guess the sizes, and then you take the bunny when he's not looking. Oh, you gotta go, Chopfla. You love to stream, but you got a movie with the wife wants to watch. Oh, that's awesome, Chopfla. What movie are you guys gonna watch? All right, we'll catch you later. Thank you so much for dropping by, and thank you again for the raid. Enjoy your movie, Chopfla. Ooh, what should we name the bunny? Phantasma. I'm so bad at naming characters, and whenever I'm playing a game and I have to name something right away, I panic. It's like, oh God, I don't know. So maybe we can bribe this guy with the bunny.
Ugh. I bet bunnies aren't allowed either. Hey, open up. Let me in.
Beat it.
Jerk.
Oh, we can't even talk to him with that. Onion. I like that name, Onion. Ooh, that's a good one, Arthur. I love a good pun. Harrison Ford. Well, is there another place here that I missed? Maybe another arrow going a different direction? I don't think so.
Our bunnies come with batteries included.
Can we send the bunny inside of there? I'm not sure. Now he's getting an incredible name, Onion Watson Harrison.
A bunny won't do much there.
No, we can't unleash the bunny there. Well, maybe
you, big feller.
We can
come
also
give our
take
derby car a spin.
We can also take
bunny.
The car
you know
potentially.
You want to.
Let's ask about the shirt again.
Excuse me, but are those shirts are they all cotton?
Well, let's just see here.
Yoink. Oh no, we can't take it. We can only try to play with it.
It's out of juice.
100% cotton. Yep. Don't be a cheap jerk. Buy something.
Is there anything else I can interact with? It doesn't look like it. And there is another location.
Official Corley Motors merchandise.
Let's see, I know of this one.
These souvenirs all
this
have
scene.
An expected appreciation rate of 300% per year.
And I don't think we could take our bike back, but I can try. Oh no, is the stream skipping again for you, Dingo? You gotta head out. Oh, we'll see you later, Dingo. Hopefully you're almost out of work. I think you probably only have like 30 minutes to go. Well, drive safe when you get off. Let's see. I thought maybe we could take our bike this way. Oh, here we go.
I don't walk.
Darn it, we were just on our bike. Or maybe I haven't actually been this way. This might be new. Yes, this is new. Oh, nice. Oh, I like those skulls on those fence.
There's the vulture's hideout on the other side of this field. I've heard a lot about the vultures. And I guess it's all true.
Oh, no. Okay, so it's a minefield. This is great. I'm going to save it. 100%. Okay, I'm a little nervous, but I feel like I'm supposed to use... It's got to be the remote control car, right? But it's out of juice. I can't unleash the bunny to set these off, right? Maybe the bunny's so fast it won't get hurt. It is going. It's doing something. Wait, is that a wind-up bunny? I think it's a wind-up bunny. I'm not sure. It looks like it has something on the side of it. Oh. Okay, we don't go that way. Oh, wait, what's this? We got a battery from the toy. Okay, it wasn't a real bunny. I thought that was a real bunny for the longest time. Okay, now that we have a battery, we can go take that RC car, bring it over there, and use that to find the other mines. Yeah, 2021 to 2021. How dare you? I was so worried. It's like, am I going to kill this bunny? Chat will never let me live it down. But then it was a toy, so we're okay.
What's a couple of bucks in exchange for a timeless memento? Don't crowd everybody. There's enough for everyone.
All right, so let's try putting the batteries in the car. Memento?
That should put some life into it.
Sure, sure. Take it for a spin. Just don't go out of range. Souvenirs to remind you of your special Smashatorium adventure.
Oh, do I take it back this way?
Lovable, lovable little bunnies.
And then, can we take it over here?
Hey, don't go in there.
Aha.
Now look what you did. The entrance is all the way through the factory. Hang on, little buddy. Daddy's coming.
Now it's just me and the bunnies.
We're going to need a lot more bunnies to set off those things, won't we? Take the whole bunny box. Yoink. Or else get the hell out of here. Don't do this at home, kids. Justice for Blob and Bear and Onion and all these animals that have not survived John Cadia. So... do we know how many bunnies we have? We're just going to unleash an entire army of bunnies on this minefield and see what happens. There are 12. There we go. A dozen bunnies. All toys. They're not real.
The minefield's been replanted. Tidy little vultures.
Those jerks. Yeah, it does say 12. You're right. Yeah. All right. Unleash the bunnies. This is great. It plays Flight of the Valkyries. One of them's going to make it all the way through. We'll have to follow that path. I guess we just follow the path of the exploded mines because you know it's going to be safe. Oh, there goes one. They're not making it very far. There's only four left. 3, 2, 1. Come on, little buddy. Oh!
Don't think so.
Hmm. Yeah, see, that's not nearly far enough. Am I supposed to go get more?
Dang, there goes another value pack.
He just realized we jacked it all. Yeah, first through the eighth. The entire family of them gone, wiped from the earth. It's so sad. It's honestly, it's just a tragedy, guys. That's all it is. Been a while since we bursted that one out. More logical. I don't know of a way I can control the bunnies, and I can't obviously like walk out there and like place them. Hmm. But I can just grab another one of these, so that's good. We grab this thing still? Almost be cool if we can
nope,
control the bunnies.
Not as much fun without the car.
It reminds me of like those video games they show in television and movies where they're playing like, I saw one, they were playing like Final Fantasy something, and there was two players with controllers, but it was obviously a single player game. Or they have a Super Nintendo controller and they're playing a PlayStation game or something like this. Like, what the heck are you doing? We're getting it so wrong.
No mementos. I'll have scars enough to remind me of this trip.
Oh, we don't have to touch any of that stuff. Okay. Wait, what is this right here? It's like highlighting where the car used to be. Oh, maybe I can, Hussy. If I didn't try clicking on them, I assumed you just kind of let them go. Let them be free. And unfortunately, they're going to replant all of those things again. But yeah. Maybe you can turn their direction a little bit? I don't know if they go in a straight line. Maybe they do. You gave them all names. Phantasma, Justin, Thomas, Aaron, Samuel, Todd, Nathaniel, Anna, Emma, Sarah, Teresa, Elaine, and Cinnabunny. Cinnabunny. Okay, since we're here, let's just go ahead and make a save that we can quickly reload if I screw something up. Not if I screw something up, when I screw something up. We need more bunnies. Artho! Oh my goodness, dude. Artho with the sub for 4 months. Oh my gosh, thank you very much, Artho. I appreciate that. Let me drop some more tokens for you guys. That was very kind of you. Oh, look at that. All those tokens spawned in the exact same spot. One jump, you'll probably get all three of them. So time that well. Thank you very much, Artho. That was awesome of you. And the poor rabbits, somebody should seed their success. Oh, there you go. Maybe that's, it takes bribery, as we've seen before. It just takes bribery. Wait, does it matter where I click on here? Let me back out of there. How do I put this away? There we go. No, I'm pressing shift and it's not highlighting anything. So I guess that it doesn't really matter. There's not like distinct sections, but maybe you can send it in a particular direction. So maybe I click way over here towards the entrance. Right about there. Oh, do I have to pick them all up? So now I have 12 individual bunnies? Okay, so I picked up all the bunnies separately. Oh, look at them. So now do I just send one at a time? I'll send it in that direction. Hey, it changed the music. Oh, there it goes. Oh, Artho, you got two of those. Very nice. And Phantasma, good catch too. Okay, so
I
now
I don't want to set off any of these boys.
Oh, I was gonna try to stand exactly where it blew up, so I know that spot is safe. Yeah, because we're kind of making a path. Okay. Unleash Cinnabon. Oh, that didn't go very far at all.
No.
Is this going to be like a terrible, kind of like what we were talking about, trial and error, where you just have to keep testing and testing and testing until you hopefully find the right direction? Like that desert puzzle? Lemmings. I love the Lemmings games. Those were so much fun.
I hate surprises.
This definitely feels like it's we're making way more progress than we did before. But dang, did they put a lot of minds here. Yeah, I think it's going to be a pixel hunt game as well. Oh, why was he going that direction?
No.
Therapy, yes. Oh, we made it. Nice. I thought I needed way more. Oh,
that's
crap.
The guy I was telling you about, Susie.
You sure?
Yeah. That's the guy who killed my father.
No, we didn't.
All right, vultures, rack him up. Let's rip him quick.
Listen, Mo, you're making a big mistake.
Oh, Ben, you're right. We shouldn't do this quickly. We should draw this out, don't you think, Susie?
Oh, dear.
Hey, I got all night. You heard her, kids. Let's draw this out.
Okay, let's just say your father was killed by Ripburger, not me.
Your father.
Don't you dare talk about my father, you heartless bastard.
There we go. Malcolm wants to take over your company.
Malcolm wants...
I said shut up about my dad.
Hey, we were friends.
Corley and I.
I said shut up about my dad.
Okay, I'm innocent. I swear.
I'm innocent.
You're in something, all right.
I'm not doing too good. That's enough.
Okay, that's enough.
Not quite.
God, I'm so scared we're just going to split in half, but I think this game was not rated M for mature. Let me go, or else.
Let me go, or else.
Or else what?
Ooh, here we go. I'll call you names. I'll get blood all over your driveway. I like that.
I'll get blood all over your driveway.
That's good for the landscaping, actually.
Okay. So we're on the right path, I think.
Let me go, or else.
Or else what?
Say, I'll tear this place apart.
I'll tear this place apart.
Ironic choice of words, Ben.
Ooh, that was getting close.
Let me go, or else.
Or else what?
I guess we'll sick the polecats on you?
I'll sick the polecats on you.
The polecats are in jail, Ben. You put them there, remember?
Oh, God.
Let me go.
There's only one more answer.
Or else what?
I'll call you names.
I'll call you names.
Like what?
Hey! Freaky toaster loving old maid. It's like the description of her to a T. She does love her toasters.
Freaky toaster loving old maid.
Oh gosh. Okay, that was not correct.
Let me go, or else.
Or else what?
I'll call you names.
I'll call you names.
Like what?
That's the next best one. This one kind of you know, talks to the biker in her. Rat bike riding rubber covered vultures.
Rat bike riding rubber covered vultures.
Nope. It's always going to be the last one, you think.
Let me go, or else...
Or else what?
I'll call you names.
Like...
Mink farmer? I don't know.
Mink farmer.
No. How do I always pick the correct one last? That's my question. And what are the odds? Not very good. Especially twice in a row.
Let me.
I'll skip some of these. Diaper Dynamo.
Diaper Dynamo.
How? Where'd you hear that name?
Your father. He told me just before he died.
I don't remember that.
Bludgeoned my father and then talked about old times.
I didn't kill him. Ripburger did. A photographer took pictures, but her camera was stolen by the same thug that came after you.
I still have that role.
Well, develop it, would you, while I still fit in my clothes?
Okay, you stay here.
Hey.
Oh, no. I completely forgot about that line about the nickname.
Sorry.
Yeah, well, don't sweat it.
I'm gonna get Ripburger even if I die trying.
No, we have to expose Ripburger at the shareholders' meeting. That way... We take him down, we save my gang, and your father gets his dying wish. You take over Corley Motors.
Ripburger canceled the shareholders meeting.
Yep.
He made a statement to the press that there'd be no meeting until the murderers were brought to justice.
So, no shareholders meeting until we're both dead?
That could be arranged.
Okay, hey. So here we go. Faking Ben and Maureen's death. Act 1, Scene 1. Adrian Ripburger, in a desperate attempt to lure our Maureen out of hiding, has developed the following lame-ass scheme. First prize at tonight's smash-up derby is a vintage hardtail that Mo restored with her dad. Rip hopes Mo will try to nab said bike on account of her sentimental attachment to it. So Ben and Mo play along, put on disguises, and enter the demolition derby, which ends tragically when their cars explode and both are presumed dead.
Question.
Please save your questions until the end. Now, the explosives in Mo's car can only be triggered by a head-on collision with Ben's car. This ejector seat projects Mo clear of the explosion, and she parachutes to safety.
Good luck
Don't
with that.
Don't you think someone will notice her ejecting out of her car?
No. They'll all be watching you running around on fire.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that's another question I have.
When your car explodes, you climb from it in flames and run around the stadium distracting the audience. In your cute little asbestos suit, of course.
That's some plan.
All right, then. Let's go blow your little darlings up.
All right,
we get to light on fire and run around to distract them.
Chili dogs, 'cause it's time to start. The Corley Motors Smashatorium Amateur Driver Ultimate Destruction.
Here's the old school version. That's cool.
Just fine with us, isn't it?
Ooh, another action scene? Nice.
Now I'm just embarrassed for them. Who do they think they're fooling with those ludicrous disguises?
And next to him is another masked newcomer. Please give a big smashatorium salute to the princess of pile-up, Doreen Schmorley.
Uh-oh. He knows.
And finally, we have a last-minute addition to the lineup tonight. A deadly-looking team known as the Boom-Boom Brothers.
Try and get away now.
Hey, there's Maurice.
Right now, are you ready to see some reckless driving? Are you ready to see some unnecessarily violent destruction?
Yeah! That was one of my favorite games on the PlayStation, was Destruction Derby.
Are you Ben?
Hang on, Mo. Here I come.
OK, Okay, how do I play this? So it looks like I can drive with the left button. This is the same game, Skywalker. You might not know it. And you can turn with the mouse a little bit. Funny thing. How are you doing? Funny thing. Good to see you. I'm just wrecking cars right now. Oh, no.
Man, what are you doing? Get over here and nail me.
Okay, so she's the yellow one, right? I think I got to get over to the yellow one. That blue car is kind of protecting her.
Watch out for the Boom Boom Brothers, Mo.
Yeah, that car just perfectly blocks me every time. Oh, we're doing really good, funny thing. How are things with you? This is my Friday, so I get to stream late tonight. So that's up, down, left, right to reverse and stuff. Oh yeah, keyboard works as well.
I can't avoid these other cars forever.
I wonder if that works better than the mouse. Maybe I need to back up and get some distance. She is number 11, which I think is the yellow one. Can't even get close enough to see it. I think it's the only car I haven't hit. Oh no, it's the orange one. I already hit the orange one. I guess I gotta hit it some more. I gotta back up and get some more distance. There we go. Oh! She dodged me. I wonder if I have to hit her in the back. Maybe I can't damage her from the front. It's very difficult to sneak around with these cars. Oh, she's not looking at me. Oh, I narrowly missed. I might be able to use the rams. Maybe I could just like land on her. Oh, she waits for me there.
That car stalled when I bounced off the roof. Looks like these babies have a glass jaw.
There we go. Let me try one more time. Oh, it stalls her, so now I can crash into her. Except that car is blocking me now. Do you think she's yellow elegant? Maybe I can use the stall car to make my way towards the other one. I'll use it like a shield, essentially. I don't know if I can do that, actually. Let me try. Oh, there's another ramp here. Never mind. Let's use this to stall the blue car. Then I can get around and get to the yellow one. Oh, I missed. Just barely. Okay. Come on, go on. Oh, not quite. I'm stuck. What does this look like in the old version? That's a huge difference. Now, was there another one? Maybe up on this side? I think the other one was the one I was just trying, huh? Maybe I have to lure him out here and then quickly use it. He's really fast. I can only seem to land like right in front of him. Maybe I have to take out the other car too. Does the green car ever go in front of here? If I can lure the green car out here, I might be able to hit them. Seriously, funny thing, huge bully. Come on, green car, come over here. Nah, they kind of stay to their area, it looks like. There's no more ramps up there. He's so fast. Now, can I push this orange car up there? Ah. This might not be the right thing to do.
Okay, Boom Boom Brothers.
Ooh.
It's all over.
Nice.
Get him. What are you doing? Are you taking a nap?
Look at that.
Idiots.
Okay, Mo. Time for our big finale.
Do it.
And, therapy.
Oh, that's an explosion, ladies and gentlemen. Can't see any survivors.
There we are, running on fire.
It's the unknown Avenger, and he's on fire.
Like NBA Jam.
Let's give him a hand, folks. That looks painful. We really should put him out right away, but what a show, huh?
They're not gonna put us out. Oh, I'm playing. I'm supposed to sneak out on fire. Oh, there's something over here.
I guess the Avenger never heard of stop, drop, or roll, huh?
I can't go that way.
Man, quit clowning around and make a diversion.
I am a diversion.
No offense, but we need a bigger
I just have to light everything on fire.
The bike is guarded.
Who cares about the bike?
Mo says it's important, so we're not leaving without it.
All right, I'll see what I can do, but I'm burning at both ends here.
Still no sign of this.
Maybe I have to light the cars on fire too. There we go. Just have to light the whole place on fire.
Let's all remain calm and yeah, you're right. The derby's over. Run for your life.
Everyone's leaving. Hey, they got the bike.
Finally. Now, squish that firefly while he's hot.
Uh-oh. Get to the exit.
Look at him run.
Hey, I jumped on his car. How you like that? Now, what do we have here? Can we use the chain? Or the tire iron? Maybe I have to wait until he gets close to here and then jump in the exit. There we go. Be really quick about it. Oh, he can follow me! That didn't work at all. Oh, I bet we have to lure him over to this big fire down here. Let me jump back on him. Give him the bunny. It's too bad they were not explosive bunnies. They're only explosive when they jump on a mine. Okay, we jumped on the car. Now when he comes over here, I'm gonna lure him into the fire. I mean, we're already on fire. Maybe he can't see us now. Oh, toasted his car.
Did you get him?
We finally got him, Bolas. That means Ripburger has to make us vice presidents now, like he promised, and give us 10,000 shares of stock each. Funny smell. What's that? The temperature light?
Oh!
On the bright side, I just made 20,000 shares of stock.
You jerk.
Time to start the shareholders meeting.
Where's the hardtail?
Poor Maurice.
All over the floor, Mr. Avenger.
What? What happened to your deep sentimental attachment to your father's vintage bike?
Ben, it's just a bike. I can put a bed together in about a half an hour. That's assuming, of course, I can find that key.
Oh, that's why she disassembled it. There's a key in there. And yeah, therapy, that's so funny. I'm guessing that you could finish the game with more or less bunnies, depending on how you do that mission. I'm not entirely sure. Oh, Shen, how are you doing, Shen? Thank you so much for the host. Welcome, Shen and Shen Stream. How are you guys doing? What were you streaming? What were you guys playing? Hopefully you guys had a great stream. How's your evening going? What is going on? We have a long stream tonight, Shen, which I'm always super excited for. I don't have work tomorrow, so I get to, instead of stream for about 3 hours, we push more like six, which is always so much fun. Shen Squad Raid. Oh, I love it. I'm doing fantastic, dude. We are playing a very old school point and click game called Full Throttle. It's basically an adventure game, but you play as a biker, which is a pretty unique scenario for these kind of games. Now, this is actually the remastered version, but we can actually change it to the classic one at any time, because you can see what it used to look like, and then jump right back into their cleaned up version, which I love it when the remasters do that. I understand a lot of them can't, because they change how the game works, but this one, it plays exactly the same, whichever way you do it, which is fantastic. How are you guys doing? What were you streaming there, Shen? Let me give you a quick shout out there, and thank you again for the raid. Let's see, you were working on some Battlefield 4. How did that go? Battlefield 4, that's like a little bit older, right? I think Battlefield 5 was the most recent, so I'm guessing that one probably came out like 3 or 4 years ago. I swear that I own that one, probably on Origin. Maybe I got it with PlayStation Plus. I'm not entirely sure. I feel like I've gotten it a couple times, but I haven't played a Battlefield game in a long time. How did your stream go? That's the one where it's very open compared to like Call of Duty and a lot more destructive, right? Like it got vehicles and things that break apart. That's always fun. Nice. Okay, so we actually just escaped narrowly from a destruction derby, and we were trying to get this bike for our friend Mo here, and as soon as she got back her sentimental bike, she tore it apart, which is confusing to us, but she needed a key, it sounds like, and I think she's still looking for it. Has lots of large destructible maps. That's the best. I wonder if they're ever going to implement a zombie mode into Battlefield. I don't think they've ever had one. Where now that's kind of commonplace in Call of Duty, they probably should do something different, otherwise it'd probably seem like copycats. But actually, the last time I played one of those kind of games was actually Call of Duty Zombies. But even that was a while ago. Okay, so let's ask her, what key?
What key are you talking about?
Key to my dad's safe. I remember he hid it somewhere on this bike. But I've looked everywhere and I can't find anything that even looks like a key.
So what's in the safe?
What's in the safe that's so important?
My dad's will. I'm counting on him to tell the truth about me, finally.
Why did he keep you a secret all these years?
He didn't want people to find out about my mom.
What's so bad about Mrs. Corley?
She wasn't my mom.
Huh.
I see. Okay. So, how do we get in the factory?
But how are we going to get in the factory?
In the back of the factory, there's a secret entrance that leads straight into Dad's office. He used to sneak me in so I could help him with his bike designs.
When he got too old to do all the work himself?
Nah, this is back when I was six.
So how do we find the secret passage in the back?
How do I find the secret passage?
Well, it's tricky. You have to wait for all the utility meters to turn black. Then you kick the wall in just the right spot and you're in.
Hey, we're good at kicking. We could do this. Wait for all the meters to go black. Kick the wall. But how do we know the right spot?
How do I find the right spot to kick?
Dad just knew exactly where to kick it. But I remember that there was this big crack in the wall. Mm. And if I lined up that crack with my eye level and kicked the wall right in front of me, this weird portal would open up.
Portal? Is this game getting all sci-fi? What if we can't find the spot?
What if I can't find that spot?
Just line up your eyes with the crack, wait for the meters to go black, and kick.
We can keep asking questions about this. This is funny. It keeps getting more and more mundane. That kicking part is pretty vague.
That kicking part is pretty vague.
Look, I was only six. Give me a break.
Poor Mo. Right? Funny thing? It's when you put it that way, yeah. Now we're just kind of whining. I'll never find the secret passage.
I'll never find that secret passage.
Hey, Ben, can't you see I'm busy? If I could find the spot to kick when I was only six, I'm sure you can find it on your own.
Touché. Touché. So, how was your flight?
How was your flight?
Well, there were some explosions during takeoff, and I landed in a minefield. But other than that, it was fine.
I'm fine, by the way. Thanks for asking.
Great. Now help me find that key.
Wow, she really cares, doesn't she? And what have you been up to? Funny thing, are you playing anything new? Watching any shows? What's going on? Busy with school, I'm assuming. So what are we in anyway? I don't actually know where we are. I guess we're still in the Vulture's hideout.
What are we in anyway?
It's a C-330 Big Mouth Industrial Cargo Jumbo Transport we fixed up. Whoa. We want to get it rolling so we can take it to biker rallies.
You're going to try to fly this thing?
Rolling, Ben. Rolling. This baby's flying days are over, just like mine.
That was a mouthful that she just said. Okay, what about when you tried to kill me?
Remember that time you tried to kill me?
Yeah, we really taught you a lesson. Get it?
That laugh sounds so familiar, doesn't it? Okay, we'll see what we can do.
I'll see what I can do.
Right.
Okay, meter's black, find the crack, and kick it. That's great. Now, what can we do here? We can look for the key ourselves. Some of these are numbered. That's kind of interesting. Actually, quite a few numbers here. Oh, and we can put them back down again. So that makes me think that there's going to be some specific order of ones we want up and ones we want down. But I'm not sure what. Oh, and school still hasn't started yet? You just started. I know that's an autocorrect, but I kind of want that game now. Verizon Zero Dawn. Instead of Eloy, you play as that guy. Can you hear me now? And there's like giant mechanical monsters everywhere. Can you hear me now? We need that crossover. Verizon Zero Dawn. And you're busy planning the move to the college town. Wait, for some reason, I thought you had already moved. Funny thing. Did you just go there for a little bit? Or what was that about? I thought you had gone, but maybe you're not fully settled there yet. Or were you in the process of moving stuff, but you're not living there? Yeah, Verizon Zero Dawn 5G. COVID edition. That's what everybody was saying. These COVID shots are giving us all 5G. It'll be great. Cell phone signal everywhere.
Here, take the photos. I don't want them. Show them to someone important if you get a chance.
Maybe we can show them to the guy in the front. Maybe he'll let us in. So you did move back to Hong Kong, but you will move over to where the school is in August. Oh, okay. I remember there was a move not too long ago. That was back to Hong Kong. Okay. When do you have to move? When does your school get started? So they're supposed to be... I don't know if I can go back down here. This whole place is on fire. Well, maybe we can. There's supposed to be a back entrance where we can kick. Oh, you already said August. My bad. Thanks. Isn't it back here? This is the exit.
It's the exit. It only spins one way, and it's the wrong way.
Yeah, I don't think that's where we're going to find that area to kick in all the meters. Because here's the front of the factory. Yeah, I was kind of hoping, Hasifa, after all the explosions and everything, we'd find another way around. But I don't see that. Maybe we can show him a photo, though.
Hey, open up.
Sorry, the meeting's already started.
I know. Let me in.
Mr. Ripburger's giving his keynote address. No interruptions.
But I'm a shareholder.
Yeah, right.
We are the shareholder. Jerk. Oh my goodness, what? Drolshanka with the sub. Thank you so much, Drolshanka. 20 months you've been subscribed to the channel. Thank you, Drolshanka. How are you doing, Drol? What is going on? What have you been up to? Let me drop some tokens in there for you guys. I really appreciate that. What is new? What is happening? Oh, and Tajay, much late, so tired. Oh, no worries at all, Tajay. Glad you could drop in and say hi. I imagine, yeah, you've been having a really rough week. Shinobi, I like that. Obi-Wan Shinobi. I've been spending some quality time with family and catching up with old friends as well. That's fun. That's the best part about, you know, going back home. That's awesome. Oh, and you were here with the Shen raid. Oh, that's great. Hey, you brought some good ones with you, Shen. You brought some good ones. Just been lurking. Oh, I appreciate that, Drolshanka. And I saw, Drolshanka, that you had been playing on Steam that game Dying Light. How do you like that? I started it with Andy the other day, and we were digging it. We haven't played it again since. We gotta make some time, but I do want to jump back into that game. So I'm going to try to... I only have two more bunnies. I'm going to try to show these pictures to this guy and see if that'll get me in.
These need more exposure than that.
More exposure... Oh, like in the meeting, we'll have to break him out. That makes sense. Hasifa, good catch. And your work week is Wednesday to Tuesday, so 6 days straight. So we're on day two of the week right now. And as of leaving tonight, you already have 20... Holy crap. That is a lot of hours in a short amount of time, Tasha. By the end of Wednesday, I guess. No, Tuesday. You're going to have way more. But... You know, you can sleep when you're dead. You make that money now while you got the energy, because you'll have less later. Okay, well, let's see if there's another way around this. Oh, looks like there's another arrow here I missed. A little dark alley we can go into, perhaps. Oh, and you have to be back in 10 hours. You got to get to sleep, buddy. I don't know how long it takes you to get ready and... You know, get to work and everything, but make sure you get a good amount of sleep when you're working that much. I got really crappy sleep last night, but with that coffee Andy just made me, I think I'll have enough to finish this game. There's something like right here to look at, the wall.
Well, this must be Mo's wall. Don't see anything special about it, except for that crack she mentioned.
Oh yeah, the crack is right there. Coffee. I wish I have coffee every time I stream. But if I did it on a normal work night, I'd get the worst sleep ever. So now before I try to kick in this crack, I think that's the crack I need to kick. Let me check out these other things. What is this?
It's sealed shut.
So that's probably what's going to open for the secret portal.
It's closed.
Oh, and Drolshanka, I also meant to ask, are you back from your trip? Or have you not gone yet? I know it was around this time, I thought, but I couldn't remember the exact dates. And you also drive a coworker in on weekdays, so you leave the house about an hour before your shift. Oh, that's even more time. Oh, it's on hold right now? I'm sorry to hear that, Drolshanka. That's no fun. I know you were super excited for that. Well, everything happens for a reason. We'll let it slide for now. Keep me updated on what's going on, of course.
These must be the meters Mo was talking about.
But I'm very sorry to hear that. Trips are fun. We just went to Disneyland not too long ago. That was a blast. Food was a pain in the butt, but the ride lines were short, so that was really cool. What is this in the corner?
Well, this must be Mo's wall. Don't see anything special about it, except for that crack she mentioned.
Okay, I'm pretty sure it's this crack right here. Yes, 100% drill. Okay, so when all of those meters have the little black line in the middle, that's when I need to kick here, I believe. So in about 3 seconds or so. Bam! Right? Oh, wrong spot. Okay. So much buildup for nothing. Oh, thank you, Drollshanka. Yeah, we had a good time. It was so weird. Some of the park places at Disneyland were super empty. Like Toontown, there was like nobody. And then other areas, like the New Orleans Square, it looked like it was just a busy day at Disneyland. There were so many people. Okay, I'm going to try to kick this spot right here. Right about now. No? Okay, maybe it's this crack over here. There are a lot of cracks here. Bam. None of them? Right here? Maybe that's the spot. Aha! There we go. Just gotta keep trying. You know, we should probably save it. Oh, and on the good side of things, you had court Tuesday morning and things went the way you had hoped. Oh, that's good. You have some fines to finish paying, but only a couple of weeks to pay them. Although it won't be a big deal because you're just waiting on the payday. There you go. And you will officially be done with a decade-old crap storm. That's so exciting, Tajay. No jail time. None of that. Just get it behind you. That's great. And no more probation. That would be fantastic. Then it's truly in the past. I'm so happy for you, dude. That's fantastic news. Okay, into the portal. Ooh, now we are in the Crowley? His office, anyway. Let me go ahead and save it. Oh, look at this. This is cool. Looks like this person's trying to run away from like the Reaper, and there's like an angel over here. I can dig that. Yeah, I've been spending most of my free time recently, Drollshanka, doing a lot of stuff around the house. We recently got a new television, finally replacing that 11, 12-year-old plasma TV that we've had forever. Finally got a new TV, got that mounted. I got some new speakers coming in, but they're going to be a little while, but I got plans to mount them and make it look all pretty. And we got a new TV stand and just kind of making everything look nice, which that TV stand, that was another. it was fun. I got to do some carpentry work. I had to make my own shelf levels because they didn't have adjustable shelves where I wanted it to be. I had to drill holes in the back, all that kind of fun stuff. But it's looking really good. I can't wait till we can have people over again and you could check it out. It'll be fun. Yeah, that was actually a much older one, but I do need to put that previous one. I'm probably going to try to sell that one, honestly, because it's the plasma TV is like 140 pounds. I can't do anything with it. Either it sits on a TV stand or I risk ripping an entire wall off trying to wall mount it. Like, the thing's massive. Wow, we are 80% done with this game. We made a lot of progress in that scene. Okay, let's check out this.
Very austere. No drawers.
No drawers in the desk. That's kind of interesting. Oh, that looks like a little push plate, doesn't it? A floor safe. Oh, this is where all those codes are going to come in that we saw as part of the key, right? So the key isn't actually a physical key. The key is a code from there. Oh, you took a picture, Hasifa. You are a lifesaver. Thank you. That'll save me time going all the way back just to look at some numbers. Let me bring that up on Discord real quick. Nice job. And it's not even like a picture from a walkthrough. It's actually a picture from the stream. You were thinking ahead. I appreciate that. Okay. So looking at these numbers, I'm curious if any of these stand out to me. Unfortunately, my head is covering one of the numbers, so hopefully that's not it. I guess you just kind of try them all. We have six numbers. It looks like all of the codes there are six. One of them has a B. Is that? Yeah, so B isn't even an option, so we can skip that one. I'll try to just go from left to right. So I'm going to say the first one is 897. Oh, crap. Is that 767 or is that dash 67? It's hard to tell. I think it's 767. Could be 167. I don't know. Okay. It's a little tough to read that one, so I'm assuming that's it. And Tajay, and to be fair, it should have been done years ago, but they failed at that communication, and you had no idea they had revoked your probation and issued a warrant. I remember you mentioning that. That was stressful. Flash forward 2 months ago when you got arrested, and the 7-year-old warrant proceeded to spend the last 2 months in anxiety overload. Oh, it's so bad. But things are turning around so quickly with a new job, new responsibility, more money, and you're getting this behind you. That is great. Yeah, you definitely need a vacation. I'm curious, as you're with the same company and you moved into a new role, do you have vacation you could just use whenever? Or are you kind of starting over with that? I would hope. Or maybe you weren't building vacation. I'm not sure how it worked in your position. But hopefully you can get vacation built up now because you're like in a salary, aren't you? Okay, so the next one is 154492. 492. Oh, Drolshenka. And actually, anybody out there that's an Xbox player, I had heard about this deal and I finally took advantage of it because I do have an Xbox Series X. Game Pass is ridiculous. Like, it's a really good deal, even if you're paying full price. However, if you don't want to pay full price, they have this thing going on. It's almost like a loophole, but it works. If you have Xbox Live Gold on your account, up to 3 years, so like up to 36 months, you can do this. However much Xbox Live Gold you have stored on your account, if you don't have Game Pass Ultimate, you can do their promotion to pay $1 to get Game Pass Ultimate, and it converts your 36 months of Xbox Live into Game Pass Ultimate. So instead of paying $15 a month, you pay $5 a month. If you go for like the 36 months or whatever it is. So you can pretty much do it as much as you want. That's a hell of a deal. Okay. Yes, yes. They were doing $1 for 3 months, but I guess it's going on for a little while now, but converting that is such a fantastic value. Oh, I got you, Tajay. Once you get to like that upper management, then you get the normal vacation. But you're finally making enough that you can save up a bit and plan just requesting a few days off and taking an extended weekend and a short trip somewhere. There you go. Haven't decided where, but it's going to happen. Especially with everything opening up. That's perfect timing. Okay, let's try this code here. Hey, that was it.
There's some sort of card. A tape. I sure hope that's Corley's will.
A card and a tape, huh? Oh, we need like a film projector.
I sure hope that's Corley's will.
And what is this card? It just says Corley Motors. That's weird. I think it's supposed to say something there, but the game is just glitching out and quickly flashing on the screen, Corley Motors. What does it do in the old version? Same thing. Okay. That's just the game. When you also just make another account, swap back and forth with the $1 deals, that's pretty impressive. Yeah, and you can share them on the main account. That's one thing I discovered with the PC version of all that is I bought Minecraft on the Microsoft store. And how did it work? I installed it on another computer and I was able to play with Andy, both of us playing that version, only owning one copy. And however they share games on computers like that, I thought that was fantastic. It's like, this is great. Does that work with every game?
Now that's art.
Of course. Yeah, Microsoft is buying up so many other companies.
Look at that stadium burn. That's going to take a bite out of the pension fund.
Oof. Game Pass just keeps getting more and more worthwhile, I suppose. Oh, let me remove that screenshot that I had up so I can see more of chat. There we go. Okay, so what's further in here? I'm scared I'm going to get caught. Oh, maybe this is where we need to use the key.
This is where you put the card.
Yeah, let's go ahead and try that.
Cool. Looks like the meeting started.
Oh, so now that there's a meeting going on.
Not only an inspirational leader, but also a great personal friend. His loss affects us all deeply. Malcolm and I spoke often of the future. We talked of a day when Corley Motors would move beyond its humble beginnings into a new vehicular age.
Yeah, I don't think he said that.
And although his tragic death took him from us sooner than anyone expected.
Fake crying.
Malcolm Corley's dream remains. And I shall carry out that dream in his memory. Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to present to you the future of Corley Motors. The Corley minivan.
No! Motorcycles to minivans?
Corley was right. I never dreamed it would actually come to minivans, though.
We gotta put a stop to this. Okay, so there's two levers over here. I don't see anywhere where I can look. Oh, maybe we have to stop the film, pull it out, and put the film we discovered on there. Try this other one.
What the hell is going on up
there? Uh-oh.
I'm on it. Just a lamp adjustment. Be fixed in no time.
Yes. Now then. I hate this old equipment. My girdle needs less adjusting.
Yeah, what was funny about that Elegant is I don't think I had Game Pass Ultimate at the time. I think I just bought Minecraft, so it was on my account. But somehow it let me log on as a different Microsoft account on a different computer. But I installed Minecraft already with my account on there, and we were able to play together, which is great. Okay, so I wonder if I can just use it here.
I don't think that plays reel-to-reel tapes.
Well, yeah, it's up here, but maybe this one stops it. That's going to bring them, so I need to do this one first.
Time to grow up.
Now, can we load this?
Turning the battleship.
Can I go this way?
Ay, ay, ay.
Uh-oh.
This is intolerable.
I'm on it. The motor speed got off is all. Hang on a minute.
Okay, so one controls the video and one controls the sound. Is that right?
Yes. Back to the presentation.
Okay, let's explore this area a little bit more. I feel like I'm missing something.
Man, that Ripburger can yap. Where does he get this crap? Hey, who are you? How long have you been there? Oh, security! Help! Security!
Uh-oh.
What took you so long? He ran down the hallway. Move it.
Mavis must be seeing things.
He is really good at hiding. Multiple times he's done that. Oh, one stops the spinning, the other one's a light. That makes sense. That's all you really need. Light and the thing to actually move, right? Okay, so what's this direction? Is this where security is?
It's locked.
Can't go there. You know, I think I need to flip one of these and then quickly go out the door and go into the room that she's coming out of. Let's go this way now. Book it in here, and she won't be in there.
Not again.
Not again.
Just a lamp adjustment. Be fixed in no time.
Yes.
Oh, I might not have had time.
Where was I?
Check out that double chin. What a stuffed shirt.
Oh, when I poke my head in there, I have a little bit of time to do something.
Jeez, my feet are killing me. When's this
Can thing I show her the pictures?
End? Ah! Help!
Nope.
Security!
It's like, hey, look at this proof. We have to wait to that put that on the guard, reel.
The big one. Catch him this time, will ya?
I probably do. I probably
this
can
is
do both switches.
Get old fast.
I was thinking maybe when it's down, I need to do something else to, like, sabotage it so it takes more work to fix, but maybe just doing both switches is enough. Okay, lamp lever, motor lever. Get the hell out of there. Fingers crossed.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Feel
you
so sorry for her.
In the control booth. Wake up!
Just readjusting the lamp and motor controls here. At least the film didn't burn, huh?
Yes. Now then. Blah, blah, blah. I sure missed old Corley. Ah!
Oh, didn't
security.
Have
security!
Could we use a bunny?
Why can't you catch that guy? Donuts weighing you down? That woman needs some sleep.
You would think some of this would have been caught on camera, right? Yeah, the only thing you can interact with is that right there. I can poke my head in here.
It's locked.
Oh no, not until she opens it.
Wheel-based stereotyping.
I'm saving that chain for my...
Oh, another way to manipulate them.
I don't think that...
Maybe I can move them faster instead of lower, like turn the lights up, you mean? I thought it was just like an on or off thing, but let me try it. Ah, there we go. Okay, that might burn
it. What you see before you right now is my vision for Christmas.
There we go. Yes. I turn the lights all the way up and turn the motor down.
This is a disaster.
You're telling me. We're going to have some major downtime here. Why don't you tell a joke or something?
There we go.
I don't know any jokes.
Yeah, I didn't realize I could move it a second time.
You know, this reminds me of an amusing anecdote. About her.
He's so fake. Whoa!
Well, I'm out of ideas.
Okay, now we should have some time. What do we have here? Is this where they load the film? What is this thing?
Now this is multimedia.
That's the reel-to-reel. Okay, let's try putting this in there.
In my conversations with the common employee...
Now, this next slide shows our new, more aggressive corporate strategy.
Oh man, actually shows him killing him. That's so brutal.
Hello there. If you're hearing this, I must have croaked. Well, people gotta move on, you know, and make room for other people. And that's what I'm here to talk about today. I've made room for someone else to take my place at Corley Motors. And it ain't that embezzling crook, Adrian Ripburger. Rip, you don't belong at the head of my company. You belong in jail.
Yep.
I let that man talk me into far too many things. Like keeping my daughter a secret. He was wrong. I was wrong. I should have stood by her.
Mm-hmm.
I hope, Maureen, that you forgive me. And that you take over Corley Motors and run it however you see fit. All right, that's enough. How do I turn this damn thing off?
Busted.
I'm sorry you had to hear that tape from one of Malcolm's psychiatric sessions.
Yeah, good luck playing that off.
He suffered many paranoid delusions. He was haunted by powerful forces of his own creation.
And here's one of them. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Maureen Corley, and do I have a heck of a story for you. By the time I'm done, you'll see why this man should be in jail. Mm-hmm. Hey! Where'd he hobble off to?
Uh-oh. There he goes.
And then
he's got the best run. He runs kind of like the T-1000 from Terminator.
Run, Ripburger. When it's time to find you, we'll just follow the shiny trail.
Yes, of course we'll have daycare facilities. Any other questions? Oh,
that was random.
Speak of the devil. Come over here, Ben. That was great, Ben. I found where we were meant to be all along.
So, after we pick up your bike, we'll go get my gang out of jail.
And then find out why my gang never showed up to help us.
Hmm.
And then you go business suit shopping.
Don't remind me.
Don't complain. You're going to be rich.
At this point, I'd settle for just a little peace and quiet.
Oh, crap. Not so much. That is a fast truck. Uh-oh.
She interrupted my speech then. She really shouldn't have. I was just about to talk about the inherent dangers of motorcycle operation.
What is that? Oh, that's the vulture.
Can't you make this damn thing go any faster?
That was where we were inside earlier. Working on that, the number puzzle. Ooh, okay, we gotta sneak around.
No room to over there.
Okay, let's try going this way.
If I touched it, it would fall off. If I touched it, it would fall off.
Oh, maybe I can break the glass. It does light up right over here. I mean, this guy is kind of a nut. Let's use it on him. Oh, there's a fuel line up there. Oh, there we go. Oh, he stopped it. Okay, we don't want to move the bike. Oh no! I ran out of time. Well, we got him.
Let me try that again.
But we didn't survive it. Okay, let me skip back to here. Okay, so far the panel's the only thing that's kind of gotten us anywhere. Boy, there's this grill too. Oh, let's try to open up the grill. What is this? There's a fan in there.
I don't think so. That fan's like a big meat grinder.
Can we toss something in there, like the chain?
I'm saving that chain. Pretty small. If I touched it, it would fall off. If I touched it, it would fall off. No.
Can't kick it or anything. Okay, let's try moving this now. He just immediately does that. Hmm. Yeah, it's gotta be something to do with this fan. Ah, too late.
No.
Okay, let's open up the grill. Oh, he breaks out his cane when we do that. Maybe we have a small chance of grabbing his cane. Oh, you gotta be really fast. Okay.
My cane!
Yoink!
More than a cane when I'm through with you, Ripburger.
Now we can shove his cane inside of here.
Again, that fan's like a big meat grinder.
There we go. And now we can tear the fuel lines. Oh no, can we kick it open?
No.
What else do we have to interact with here? Not much else. Oh, maybe we have to do something with him. Oh, we can attack Ripburger.
I didn't know I was back here. I'd read it.
Let's see. We can't go back that way. We can go in here. He did flip a truck, but he can't pull the cable. Do we need to do something with the bike now?
If I touched it, it would fall off. I'm not putting my lips on that. Don't think so.
If we could take the fan out, we could use that to maybe cut the cords. Let's see if it gives us a clue. No, I tried looking at it. Can we bite through it?
I'm not putting my lips on that.
Wait, I think there's four different lines. Maybe I just keep clicking the same one. Yeah, we can interact with all of them.
Won't budge.
Maybe just one of them needs to be loose.
Won't budge.
Okay, this one looks all twisted. Oh, it was loose.
No.
Do it again. It's like he's starting to do it. Maybe there's an order to it. So you start with this one. Let's see, look at the line. Or is there, I see what you mean, like for a clue with this one in particular. He just says, Boom.
Damn.
Okay, luckily we can get there real fast. Grill. This guy, grab his cane.
My cane.
Nice.
You need more than a cane.
And then use the cane and the fan. Oh, if you try to put the bunny with the fan, does that give you an achievement? Ah, I missed that. So we no longer have the cane anymore. Let me try looking at the one that's loose. It's almost like we have to loosen the end right here. Did I try this one? I think I tried them all. He also pulls them a certain number of times. Like that time he tried it three times. That one's once. I wonder if that has something to do with it. No, I think it's always three times. Okay. If I hold shift, there's nothing else I can interact with, I don't think. What if I come back here? I think I just have to scan with my mouse because it doesn't show me the things I can interact with.
I'd rather he didn't know I was back here.
Oh, too late. Alright, open the grill, get our cane. I gotta try the bunny first.
My cane.
I guess I actually don't need the cane
when I'm through with you, Ripburger.
If the bunny does something, but we could try it. Just poof, gone. Fun. Doesn't accomplish anything, but it's fun. Oh, we have used the pipe wrench in the past. He keeps saying like it's only for the fighting, so I kind of gave up on it, but he has used that before. Aha, thank you. Oh crap! Yoink! Holy cow! This guy's well prepared. Oh, it's falling apart.
I thought you said this thing couldn't move.
I said it couldn't fly. I never said it couldn't taxi. Well, flying would be nice since we're headed for the gorge.
Ripburger, you're going to kill all of us.
Shh, Ben, don't ruin it.
He's killed me
How
multiple
do you stop
times.
This thing?
From the cockpit.
Maybe you should go to the cockpit.
Doc! Careful, Ben.
Oh, I just have to time this, I think. He can't keep shooting, so we just go in between his shots. There we go.
So much for the controls. I could have used those.
Okay, those are all electrified. Can't
Damn.
Touch those.
Busted. Don't mind if that's trash.
Oh, crap. No, stay up there. I accidentally clicked out. How about that?
Not working.
Oh, there we go. We can turn the screen on. Landing. Emergency. Control loss. Brake system. Emergency brakes. Rear brakes. Both brakes. Yes. The system has been severely damaged and is not responding. Oh no. Emergency. Control loss. Brake system. Drag chutes. Full deployment. Also disabled. Darn it. Emergency. Control loss. Navigation. Heading unknown. Nope. Emergency engine failure. That doesn't look right. Military crisis. Passenger control. Oh no. Slightly bigger explosion. Much bigger vehicle.
Oh, let me try that again.
Oh good, it drops me off there. Hey, I didn't even get shot at that time. We were able to just go straight through there. Nice. Okay, so let's say landing. Runway landing. Manual controls. Oh, nope. Oh, let's try to neutralize this guy, maybe. I wonder if that'll help. Nope. It's like, can we shoot at the tank? I don't know. In flight. Autopilot. Engage. Okay, no autopilot. Takeoff. Mid takeoff. Acceleration. Let's jump the thing. Crap. logarithmic. I think that's not it. Okay. That might still be it. Mid takeoff, flaps, attenuate. I'm just trying each system once to find one that actually has something that works. Cruise settings. Nope. Ah, oh, darn it.
No. Let me try that again.
Thank goodness you can quickly skip through repeated scenes. That makes it go by so much easier. It's going to be the last system that I try. It always is. Ooh, what is important on the ground, but not while you're in the air? I think that's landing. Ditch? Crash instructions? Nope. Let's throw on a movie. Adults only. Oh, we almost got it. In flight. Entertainment. Games. Oh, that's important to me. But not while in the air. Approach patterns? Whoa, what is all this? I have no idea what that meant. Air traffic. Oh, I didn't quite get to do the air traffic. I'll do that one next. Although air traffic is important in the air, so that doesn't make sense. Our gear? Detach gear. Will that ditch him? Nope. Let's see what else we can do post takeoff. I already tried systems check before, I think. Raise gear.
Here goes nothing.
Oh, no more wheels. Now we're gonna brake, actually. Just gotta find the one system that's not broken. Uh-oh. Nice save. Oh my gosh. How are we alive?
Ben, are you alive?
I am, but I don't know about Ripburger.
I can see him. He's out cold. Climb back here quick.
No, he's not.
Can't reach him.
We should probably go get Ripburger. Oh. Fuel tank link. The vehicle has been reported as stolen. Defense menu. Machine guns. Control. Aim. Lower? We can't move the turret. Let's just fire him.
I think you just killed a seagull.
I got an achievement for that. Let's see. And Merc, destroy them all. I'm trying. At least one of these guys. Oh, if we can retract the gun, then it'll drop him, right? Defense menu, machine guns, control. Oh, no. I think I was too late. If anything, I can turn any game into a murder simulator. Oh my gosh.
Let me try that again.
Definitely killed myself many times.
Climb back here quick.
Not quite yet. I'm gonna take care of Ripburger. Okay, main menu, defense, machine guns, control, system off. Will that retract it?
Hey!
That was great. The Wile E. Coyote fall.
Well, that answers that.
Let's get the hell out of here. It said on the license plate, can't beat a Corley. That was fantastic. As much as he tries. How are you doing, Merc? What's going on?
Wait, come back. We need your weight in the plane.
Run, run, run. We don't have time. Oh, I don't think we made that.
Try that again.
Because there's something else. Oh, I have to do all that again? Okay.
Climb back here quick.
At least I know where everything is. Allergy season is beating you. Oh no, but it's almost over. Otherwise, not too much new. Things are great over here. Been mostly just doing like some jobs around the house, fixing some things up. We got a new TV mounted on the wall. I've been running speaker wires all through the attic, that kind of stuff. So a lot of house projects, that kind of thing. And I have a 3-day weekend this weekend, so that's really exciting. Okay, so it was under defense, machine guns, control, off. It'll be satisfying to watch him drop again. See ya. Actually, I work what they call a 980 schedule.
No, poetic.
Oh no, I tried to use the computer again and that just killed me.
Damn.
So don't do that, John.
Climb back here quick.
I work 980s, which means I work 9-hour days instead of 8-hour days, so I get every other Friday off, and it's fantastic. I don't really notice the extra hour at work, but I definitely notice that extra day off every 2 weeks. Okay, so let's retract him one more time. Go ahead and skip this, and now we're just going to run for it. I could probably do 4 10s and get every Friday off, but I think that 10-hour day, especially when I'm going into work, would start to feel kind of long. If I was working at home 100% of the time,
wait,
that wouldn't
back.
Be too bad.
We need your weight in the plane.
Okay, oh, my motorcycle's back there. Am I supposed to do something with that? Gosh, I don't have like hardly any time to do anything there.
Climb there back must be here quick.
There must be some object I missed I'm supposed to interact with. Unless I have to do more things here. Don't do that.
Climb back here quick.
We cannot use cargo for defense. We recommend alert defensive driving to prevent hijacking situations. I think, funny thing, I'm not climbing back there quick enough.
That's what having a regular job will do to you.
I was thinking there might be something else, Tsushima, like that, that we have to set up before we go, but I'm not sure. That might be true.
Wait, come back! We need your weight in the plane!
Maybe that's the problem, is they're escaping. Maybe we need to keep it closed. Yeah, see, I can't interact with the bike. I don't think I can interact with anything here. Oh, wait, I moved! You can move the screen. Never mind. It just wasn't highlighting where I was. Much better. Go, 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 go! Yeah! Oh, that's cool. Even his, like, weird Terminator run wasn't quick
Life
enough.
It was a game to him.
Aww.
And he played it. By his own rules.
He was a mystery to most of us. And yet, an inspiration to us all. He gave us freedom. He gave us power. He gave us wings. He gave us wheels. Thank you, Malcolm Corley, for giving us a dream that will never die.
So, maybe we could do lunch sometime next week.
Yeah, sure. Lunch sounds great.
Things aren't gonna change, are they, Ben? I mean, just because I'm in charge of the company now, and living in a mansion and riding around in limos, that doesn't mean we won't spend a lot of time together, does it?
Look, Mo, you're in a different league now. You shouldn't be hanging out with the likes of me anymore.
But Ben...
Aww.
Just a second. Hello? What? No, that's crazy. Is he nuts? Look, move the meeting up to 5 and tell the plant foreman that I'm coming over personally to inspect those parts. I know, that's what I told him. Excuse me, what was that last part? No, that alloy was flawed to begin with. Uh-huh, yeah. Yeah, good. Great.
Oh, she's a natural, but... Yeah, just different world for poor Ben. That was cool. In memory of Roy Conrad. What a cool game. Therapy, you might have passed out by now, but thank you so much for the recommendation. That game was super fun. And it was very kind of like bite-sized, at least from what I remember of other LucasArts games. It definitely felt like it went at a brisker pace. And just had a lot more action and more exciting things going on. I really enjoyed that one. Without some nudges in the right direction, I definitely got stopped a few times. But I really enjoyed it. What did you guys think of that game? We haven't played a point-and-click game on this channel for a little while, so it was really cool to kind of go back to that genre, you know, for once and in a long time. Good to revisit it.